Hi everyone, welcome to TweeTeach. In continuation to the series Quant Without Maths, today I am going to solve an exercise on percentage. This exercise is designed keeping in mind the level of difficulty of any campus recruitment exam. The models covered in this exercise are more than enough to crack any campus recruitment exam. Please pay attention and subscribe to our YouTube channel. To be frank, besides percentages, number system is also one of the basic foundation to solve any problems in quantitative aptitude. In solving the problems of time and work, time and distance, ratio and proportions, mensuration and so on. Whatever topic you may choose, you need to have a deeper understanding on percentages. With this introduction, I will start my exercise. See the first question. A person's salary has increased from 7200 to 8100. What is the percentage increase in his salary? Given options are 25%, 18%, 16 2/3%, 12.5%. So this question is lifted from previous TCS campus recruitment exam. Now here they have given the data that the person's salary is increased from 7200 to 8100. Now according to our previous discussed concept, according to that, when a person's salary is increased, we should write in such a way that the difference between the original salary to the increased salary, that is 8100 minus 7200, which is nothing but equal to 900. According to our previous discussed concept, percentage increase is increase by the previous or the actual salary, that is nothing but 7200 into 100. If you simplify this fraction, you will get the answer as 12.5%. Now how to simplify this fraction? This is nothing but 900 can be written as 9 into 100 by 72. So in 9 table, 9 1 times and 72 8 times. So we need to calculate 1 by 8 into 100. Now solve what is the value of 1 by 8. So 1 divided by 8. So 0.0, 1 times 8, again 2. We have already decimal, so write down 0 besides 2. So we will get 2 times 16 and the difference is 4. We have already decimal, so again write down 0, here 5, 40. So the value of 1 by 8 is 0.125 into 100. So that is nothing but when we multiply it with 100, the decimal will move two places to the right side. So it will become 12.5%. So this 12.5% can be written as 12.5%. So 12.5% will be our answer. If you go on solving problems in this manner, it takes lots of time and you may go out of competition. How to solve this problem in a very shortest way? I will explain you. First, observe the options. They have given 25%, 18%, 16 2/3%, 12.5%. So what we have to actually find out is, what is the percentage increase of the difference between the increase 8100 minus 7200, that is 900. So we have to actually find out the percentage increase of this 900 with regarding to the 7200. What is the percentage of 900 in 7200? So that is 900 by 7200. If you are able to find out what is the percentage of 900 in 7200, then we are done with the problem. Now what is the 10% of 7200? So according to our dot method, 10% means we will get 720. This 720 value is nearer to 900. So this is nothing but our 10%. So 720 is 10% and we require the value of 900. So the answer should be very nearer to 10%. So by observing the options, we can exclude 25%. We can also exclude 18%. We can also exclude 16 2/3%. So the only option we are left with, 12.5%. So this will be our correct answer. If you solve problem in this manner, it will not take time more than 10 to 15 seconds. But if you choose this lengthy process, it will kill your time. Here the options are so divergent. Suppose if the options given are very close, then you need to solve this entire lengthy procedure. There is no other option. See the next question. There are 1240 employees in an organization, out of which 25% are promoted. How many such employees are there who got promotion? See, simply 25% is nothing but 1 by 4th. Of what? 1 by 4th of the total employees. So, 1 by 4 of the total employees are 1240. Okay, this is in 4 table 1 times, this is 3 times 1 times 0. So, we will get 310. So, the number of employees who got promotion are 310. So, option C is our correct answer. See the next question. The difference between 78% of a number and 59% of the same number is 323. What is 62% of the number? Here the number is unknown. So let us take that the number is equal to x. They have given the difference between 78% and 59% of the same number. So 78% of x minus 59% of x is equal to 323. So 78% means 78 by 100 into x minus 59 by 100 into x. That is equal to 323. 78 by 100 is equals to 0.78x minus 59 by 100 is equal to 0.59x. That is equal to 323. So the difference between 0.78 and 0.59 is 0.19x. That is equal to 323. So x is equal to 323 divided by 0.19. So that will be equals to 1700. Now we need to find out 62% of the x. So 62% of what is our x value? It is 1700. So 62% of 1700 is equal to 62 by 100 into 1700. So that is equal to 17 2s are 34, 17 6s are 102, 102 plus 3 105. So 1054 is our answer. So option A is our correct answer. Now let us see what is the shortcut. So the difference between these two percentages is 19, but we will round it off to 20 to make the simplification easy. So 20% of a number is given as 323. They have asked us to calculate 62%. So roughly we will calculate 60%. So 60% means nothing but thrice of this number. That is 3 into 20% is nothing but 60%. So I am calculating 3 into 323. So that is nothing but equal to 969. Our answer will be the options which are closer to 969. So see the options. Here we have option A and option C, that is 1054, 1037 are closer to 969. We can effectively eliminate option B and option D by simply observing the value. Now out of these two options, one answer will be correct. So if you have no time and if you need to solve this problem, you can use this shortcut trick and take a chance. The answer will be either in A or C. So if you take a risk, there may be a chance of for you to get a correct answer. Even though there is negative marking, blindly mark either option A or C, whatever you may like. By doing so, there is 50% chance your answer may be correct. So friends, don't leave such type of questions for bank clerical examinations. For a total post of 6,000, 40 lakh students are applying. If you want to overcome the competition, you have to take risks. It doesn't mean that you put your head in lion's mouth. That means just blindly ticking the answer. Have a strategy, take a calculated risk, you will succeed. See the next question. A says 20% of his monthly salary. If his monthly expenditure is 6,000, then his monthly savings is... So, in order to solve this problem, first they have given that 100% of the salary, let it be x. 100% of his salary be x. Now they have given that 6,000 is his monthly expenditure and 20% is his savings. So, out of 100%, if you remove 20% of the savings, it is nothing but our expenditure, that is 6,000. So, 100 minus 20% of x is nothing but 80% of x is equal to our 6,000 rupees. 80% of x is equal to 80 by 100 of into x is equal to 6,000. From this, you will find out his monthly income, that is x value will be obtained. And from that, again, you will calculate 20% of the x value. Then you will get the savings. So our shortcut method is avoid this lengthy procedure and According to the given information, they have given 20% is his savings and his monthly expenditure is simply out of the total, if 20 is his savings, the remaining is his expenditure. So out of 100, 20 is his savings, the remaining 80% is his expenditure. Now 80% expenditure is equal to 6000 rupees. We need to find 20% of his monthly salary. So if I divide this equation by 4, I will get 20%. So 6000 divided by 4 is nothing but 1500 rupees. So 20% is equal to 1500 rupees. So simply we can solve this sum in a single step. So no need to solve this whole lengthy procedure. So solve this in this simple procedure. You will find out the answer very easily. So option C is our correct answer. See the next question. A number is increased by 137.5% and the increment is 33. The number is, the given options are 27, 22, 24, 25. So according to our question, we don't know the number. So let it be some x. 137.5% of x. So 137.5% of the x value is equals to 33. So 137.5% is nothing but 137.5 by 100 into x is equal to 33. So x is equal to 33 into 100 divided by 137.5. You need to change it into normal fraction and you need to calculate the whole value of this division. So it takes a lot of time. So we can't take a chance. So let us try to solve this in a shortcut method. First, try to understand the question. They have given a number is increased by 137.5%. That means from the given options, if we increase 137.5% value of the given options, we will get 33. Here the options are very close. So elimination is also not that much easy. Then what is the shortcut? For the sake of simplification, let us round off this 137.5% to 140%. Now this is nothing but 100 plus 40%. Now I will be finding 40% of each option. First let us take option A, 27. So 40% of 27. So to make it much simpler, let us take this as 50%. So what is 50% of 27? It is 13.5. Now we need to eliminate 10% from this. So what is 10% of 27? It is 2.7. Roughly take it as 3. So if we subtract it, we will get 10.5. So if I am adding 10.5 to this 27, I am getting 37.5. But our desired value is 33. So simply eliminate option A. Now let us move to the second option, 22. So 40% of 22. 10% is 2.2. 40% means simply multiply it with 4. We will get 8.8. So 8.8 plus 22, 31.0. But 31 is not equal to 33. So eliminate it. Now let us find for 24. So 10% of 24 is 2.4. So 40% is into 4. We will get 9.6. 9.6 plus 24, that is equal to 33.6. This value is so close to our answer. So the option may be correct. So keep it aside. So we will calculate for 25 also. So 10% is 2.5, 40% is equals to 10. So 25 plus 10, we are getting 35. This is far away from 33. So eliminate option D. The only option which is close to 33 is option C, because the value is 33.6. Why this error has occurred? Because we have rounded off this 37.5 to 40%. So for that we have got 0.6 extra. So our option is option C, 24 is our correct answer. Friends, taking approximations is nothing wrong. Here I am rounding off this 37.5 to 40%. So I am applying this 40% to all the options as it is. End of the day, the examiner is asking us to find out the answer, but he is not checking whether which steps we are doing or what is the approximation we are taking. So always round off the approximation values to make the simplification much easier. So don't waste your time by calculating complex values. This is the reason we named this series as Quant Without Max. See the next question. A man loses 20% of his money. After spending 25% of the remainder, he has rupees 480 left. What is the amount of money he originally had? So initially they have given that he has lost 20% of his money. So what is the percentage of money he had left with? 100 minus 20% of the total money. Here they did not given the total amount, so let it be x. So 100 minus 20% of x is nothing but 80% of x. And the next condition given is after spending 25% of the remainder. So after spending 25% of the money, that is 100 minus 25% of the remainder amount is 80% of x, of 80% of x is equal to 480 rupees. So that is equal to 480. So that is nothing but equal to 75 by 100 into 80 by 100 into x is equal to 480. You should find out the value of x. So you need to calculate x is equal to 480 into 100 into 100 divided by 75 into 80. So wherever possible, refrain from using variables. Variables have their own utility, but if you use variables, it will generate such complex calculations. So then what is the shortcut? I will explain you the shortcut. In percentages, when no value is given, assume that value as 100. So in this particular example, the actual amount is not given. So assume that total amount be 100 and proceed to solve the problem. Let us solve now using shortcut method. Initially, the man is having 100 rupees. He uses 20% of his money. Out of 100, 20% means it is equal to 20 rupees. So the money he is having now is 100 minus 20 rupees, that is equal to 80 rupees. Now they have given, after spending 25% of the remainder, he has 480 rupees left. So 25% of the remainder, what is 25%? 25% is nothing but 1 by 4th. 25th of the remainder amount. So 25th means nothing but equal to 1 by 4th of the remainder amount. What is the remainder amount here? 80 rupees. So write down 1 by 4 of 80 is nothing but equal to 20 rupees. Now this 20 rupees, he has spent it. Now the amount which is unspent out of this 80 rupees is 80 minus 20. That is equal to 60 rupees. Now he is left with 60 rupees. But according to the question, he is left with 480 rupees. That means this 60 rupees is equivalent to 480 rupees. According to the question, what did they ask us to find? They asked us to find the amount of money he had originally. That means we assumed it as 100 rupees. So if 60 rupees is equivalent to 480 rupees, what is 100 rupees equivalent to? So that is equal to 100 by 60 into 480. This is 1 time, 8 times, that is equal to 800 rupees. So initially or originally he is having 800 rupees. So option C is our correct answer. So friends, now think which method is easier. If you are taking the variables x and y, it is taking a lengthy procedure and also killing a lot of time. So always refrain using x and y in percentages. Always go for the shortcut. You will get accurate results. Let's see the next question. This is one more example why you should refrain the variables x or y in percentages. I never told that you should not use variables in percentages. Just refrain the variables in the particular context. What I am saying is just refrain using variables. In majority of the examinations like CAT, you should solve the problems by using variables. Uses of variables in percentages has its own context, but not in this particular case. Let us solve this question. Two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than a third number. What is the percentage of second with respect to the first? Here they have given three numbers totally. So the first number is 20% more than the third number. So when we are solving it by using the variable x as unknown, you need to take 1.2 of x. And the second number is 50% more than the third number. Then you will be taking 1.5 of x. And the third number as x, and you will be solving them and you will find out the value x and again you will find out the percentage of second with respect to first. It takes lot of time and many calculations. So to avoid it, follow the shortcut method. So here the unknown number is third number. So I am taking that as 100. And the first number is given as 20% more than the third. So this is our third number. Now our first number will be 20 more than 100. So it will be simply equal to 120. And the second number is 50 more than the third number. So second number is 50 more. What is our third number? 100. 50 more than 100 means 150. Okay. Now they have asked us to find out the percentage of second with respect to first. So percentage of second with respect to first. So percentage of second means the number which we have treated as second is 150 divided by the first number, that is nothing but 120. Since they have asked us percentage, so write down into 100. So that is nothing but equals to here 4 times, 5 times in 30 table, again 4 in 4 table 1 time, and 100 is 25 times. 25 5s are 125. 125. So here this, since it is a percentage, write down 125 percentage. So here option A is our correct answer. Now see, we have solved it in a simple, not more than 4 steps. But if you treat the unknown variable as x, it is taking a lot of steps and also much more time. So always use the shortcut and find out the answer in a less time. Friends, you don't need to do even this calculation also. See here, the second number is 150 and first number is 120. And see the options. Observe the mindset of the examiner. Here he has given 125, 90, 80 and 75. According to our question, we need to find percentage of second number to the first number. Second number is greater than the first number. So automatically the percentage will be greater than 100. So we can eliminate B, C, D options. The only option which is greater than 100 given to us is 125, that is option A. Simply you eliminate this shortcut method also and you can write down simply option A is our correct answer. If you have understanding of the concept, you can solve this problem in a very few seconds. See the next question. In a school, 10% of boys are equal to 1/4 of the girls. What is the ratio of boys is to girls? In general method, what you will do, you will take a boys as some x and girls is equal to some 1/4 of the girls is equal to some 10% of boys, and you will be keep on solving the equations and you will find out some answer. It will take lot of time. But here I will tell you two shortcuts method. So which one you want to follow, it's your wish. So it's your wish to follow whatever method or whatever shortcut you like. Now see shortcut 1. Here they have given 10% of the boys are equal to 1/4 of the girls. Here both boys and girls are unknown quantities. They didn't give us. So let I'm treating as total number of boys is equal to 100. So here I'm considering the total number of boys as 100. So total number of boys are 100. So boys are 100. Now 10% of boys are equal to 1/4 of girls. So 10% of this total number of boys is equal to 1/4 of girls. Now girls is equal to 4 into 10% of boys means 10. So that is equal to 40. Now they have asked us to find out the ratio of boys and girls. So see here, ratio and proportions are also solved by using the application of percentages. So that's why I have said percentages are the basic to solve many of the problems in quantitative aptitude. Now coming to back to our question. Here they have asked ratio of boys is to girls. So total number of boys are 100 is to girls. So that is equal to 5 is to 2. So this is one shortcut method. Now I will try to solve this in much more simpler way or without even calculating the answer. So let us see the shortcut 2. Shortcut 2 is they have given, simply write down the condition, 1/10 of the boys is equal to 1/4 of the girls. Now I am taking girls is equal to 4 into some quantity, that is 1/10 into number of boys. So let it be a quantity. So this number into 4, that means girls is compulsory a multiple of 4. So if number of girls is a multiple of 4, it will also be a multiple of 2. Why? Because 4 is nothing but 2 into 2. So we can write 2 into 2 of some quantity. So girls is a multiple of 2 into some quantity. So 2 into some quantity means conformly, by observing the options, the girls should be a multiple of 2. So here 2 is there, here also 2 is there. Here 1, 3. So we can eliminate option C and D. Because girls is a multiple of 2, in the ratio we will conformly get the multiple 2. So in both A and B we are having 2. Now coming into the boys. From this equation only, boys is equal to 10 into some number of girls by 4. So let it be some quantity. Now this 10 can be written as 2 into 5. That means the boy should be either a multiple of 2 or a multiple of 5. Already we have eliminated two options. From the given two options, we are having the ratio proportion to boys 3 and 5. So from the value which we have obtained, we should get either a multiple of 2 or 5. So 3 is not a factor of 10. Why? Because only 2 and 5 are factors of 10. So option A can be eliminated, and the only answer which we have is option B. 5 is to 2 is our correct answer. So option B is our correct answer. Since I am explaining you, it is taking at least 20 seconds to obtain the answer. But if you know the concept thoroughly, you can solve this sum in less than 10 seconds. And you can also solve this sum 10 to 15 seconds. So either of the methods is very easy. So follow any of the methods. Use shortcuts rather than other methods. So option A is our correct answer. Now let us move into the next question. Now see here, the question given is the sum of 15% of a positive number and 20% of the same number is 126. What is 1/3 of that number? So in such type of questions, when we are considering variable, we will consider 15% of that x plus 20% of x is equal to 126. You will solve it, you will get x value, and you will find out 1/3 of that x value. So it takes number of steps, but I will show you a shortcut method here. Here we don't know what is the number. So according to our concept, what we should consider? Yes, take the unknown number as 100. So 15% of 100 is 15 and 20% of 100 is 20. They have given that sum of 15 of positive number and 20 of the same number. So sum means do the addition. That is equals to 35. So according to our question, sum of 15% and 25% equal to 126. But according to our assumption, we got 35. That means this 35 is equivalent to 126. Now they have asked us to find 1/3 of that number. So 1/3 of that number means we have assumed the unknown number as 100. So 1/3 of 100 is 100 by 3. This is nothing but equals to simply around 33, or the value is 33.33. 35 is equal to 126. Now the value of 33.3 should be somewhat just less than 126. See the options here. The only option which is nearer to 126 is here. Only option C, 120. All other values are, see, the first and second options are much more greater than 120. And option D is very, very less than 120. So the only option which is very near to 126 is option C, that is 120. So option C is our correct answer. So see here, you did not consider variable, or you did not do at least 5 steps also. Just for you to understand clearly, I written 15 plus 20 is equal to 35. Otherwise, you can simply, by looking itself, you can calculate 15 plus 20 equal to 35. So that is equal to 126. But we need to find 100 by 3. So that is approximately 33. So 35 is equivalent to 126. 33 should be somewhat nearer to 126. That is somewhat less than 126. So the only option here is 120. So without putting pen on the paper itself, you can solve this problem. Okay. I hope you all understand this. Now let us move into next question. See, in this question, they have given in an office, 40% of the staff is female. 40% of female and 60% of male voted for me. The percentage of votes I got was. So here, if you solve it by using an unknown variable x, the total number of office persons as x, and you will take 40% of that x is female, and 100 minus 40%, that is 60% of them are men, and you will calculate that 40% of, again, how many female are there? 40% of x plus men are 60% of the x, but 60% of 60% of that x has voted. So you need to find out the percentage value of this. So it will be complicated. So you can use shortcut method here. So here let us take the unknown number, that is the total number of members in the office is equal to 100. Now male are 40%. Now female are 40%. So the number of female persons are 40% of 100 means simply 40, and the rest male members are 60%. Now they have asked us to find out the percentage of votes he has got if 40% of female. According to our dot technique, 10% of 40 is 4. We need to find 40%. So into 4, so we are getting here 16. First find out 10% of 60, that is 6, into 60%. So multiply it with 6, we are getting 36. So we need to find the ratio, the percentage of votes he has got. So simply add those two, you will get 52. That means 52% of them has voted for him. Otherwise, you can simply say, no need to do calculation also. Here they have given 40 are female. According to the question, 40% are female. That means 40 are female and 60 are male. And 40% of female have voted. So less number of people. Who are less number of people? Female are less in number. So less number of people have voted for him. Less percentage. So less percentage of less number of people have voted. And 60% of male. Male are 60. They are greater in number. And 60, majority of them has voted for him. So according to that, if we see less number of people has voted in less percentage, and more percentage of people have voted who are in more number. So we will get, according to that condition, the answer will be greater than half of the percentage, that is greater than 50. So in the options, the value which is greater than 50 is just option D. If you don't remember this concept also, we can easily say the value 40% and the value 40 and 60% is revolving around 50%. So answer will be just greater than or less than 50, that is plus or minus 50 itself, but not very much less than 50 or very much greater than 50. So from that we can eliminate option A and B. So if you don't know correctly, you can, if you have less time, you can either mark answer C or D. So according to the probability, even though they are negative marking, there is a chance for you to get the answer correct. So it's your wish to keep C or D. Otherwise, by simply saying less number of people, less percentage, more number of people, more percentage. So the answer should be greater than half of the percentage. So it should be greater than 50. So only option out of these two greater than 50 is 52. So no need to do this calculation also. So that's why I'm saying, as far as possible, try to avoid the usage of variables. Follow only the shortcuts. See the next question. So the question given here is, Matthew scored 42 marks in biology, 51 marks in chemistry, 58 marks in mathematics, 35 marks in physics, and 48 marks in English. The maximum marks students can score in each subject are 60. How much overall percentage did Matthew get in this exam? So here, in such type of sums, there will be no shortcut, but if we consider a risk factor, we can do that shortcut also. First, let us solve this traditionally. So here they have given, he scored 42 marks in biology, 51 marks in chemistry, 58 marks in mathematics, 35 marks in physics, and 48 marks in English. So the total number of marks he has scored is 234 marks. So the maximum marks a student can obtain are, total there are 5 subjects. So 5 into 60, that is equals to 300 marks. They have asked his overall percentage. That means the marks which he has scored by total number of marks into 100, that is equal to 78%. So such types of problems you should do it. And if you consider a risk factor, suppose you are approaching the end of the time during your examination and there is no time to solve this problem. So first, in such cases, observe the options given here. See here, 76, 82, 68 and 78. Last option is none of this. So out of this all options, 76 and 78 are somewhat nearer and both are starting with 77. That means they are nearer to 70%. In most of the cases, we can say that the answer will be in either A or D. I am again repeating, in most of the cases, the answer may be in between A or D. You may think, ma'am, here they have given none of these. It may be also the answer. Yes, but they have given this option in order to deviate us from this A and D option. So you should take a risk. Sometimes even though the options are somewhat alike, the answer may be none of these also. If you attempt such questions, there is a probability for you to be correct answer. And if negative marks are there also, if it is correct, you will get more marks, no? So some questions need to be attempted in such a way. See the next question. A water pipe is cut into two pieces. The longer pipe is 70% of the length of the pipe. By how much percentage is the longer piece longer than the shortest percentage? We don't know the length of the pipe, so take it as 100. Now 70% of the length means the length of the longer part will be 70 and the shorter one will be 30. Now they have asked how much percentage is longer piece longer than the shorter piece. So the longer piece is how much longer than the shorter? That is 70 minus 30. So it is the longer piece is longer than the shorter piece by 40. So they have, since they have asked the percentage, write down 40 by 30 into 100. 00 gets cancelled. So we will get 400 by 3%. So out of the options, option B is our correct answer. This is our shortcut method. If you solve it regularly, you should consider or you will consider the length of the pipe Vx and 70% is the longer and 30% is the shorter and you will solve it lengthily. Other than that, rather than eliminate this x and just take the total value or the total length of the pipe as 100. Let us close our session here. I hope you all understood this problem. Try to solve as many as problems in only shortcut ways so that you will save your time and also the complexity, calculation of complex values. Okay. Thank you, students.